It's cool, it's procedural, and it was made with my own add-on. But I couldn't figure out how. Dear CG Thinkers, welcome! Today we are going to create this procedural texture which made me feel pretty silly when Nickname, a Discord member, posted it and I thought it was a mistake. But no. It was a big moment of confusion, but kindly he pointed me in the right direction. After working hard for a while, I got this result, and I will explain everything to you. Let's get started.
Digital, share knowledge, grow together.
Start by selecting one of the objects and add a material that I will call Kids Coloring. Press the A key to select all the objects, then Ctrl L to link materials. Now, all the objects have the same material. Let's go to the Shader Editor. Select the principal BSDF and add a layer. For the grid, go to the Materializer library in the Man-Made section and choose the Say Yes node. Connect the color output to the color input. Next, set the scale to 60, the line thickness to 0.04, and the line spacing to 0. For the margins, we don't need any hair. Set position to -1, top to 85, and bottom to 0. That is a good start. Now, let's move on the coloring effect. Everything starts with a Voronoi texture. Let's use the 4D option so we can change the seed. Then choose the F2 style. Increase the scale to about 160 and add the essential texture coordinate node. Use the UVs and you will see the result is homogeneous. It's not magic, I just prepared the UVs before recording. Add a mapping node to the connection and, unusually, change the tip to texture. Rotate the coordinates by 45 degrees along the Z-axis. Then, adjust the scale to stretch the texture and create pencil-like strokes. It's a coloring, so where is the color? Let's add a mix color node. The Voronoi distance output goes into factor, the grid into input A, and the color is the input B. The X color for my blue is 2C79BB. Duplicate the two nodes and just change the rotation by 5 degrees. Now, add a math node to combine the result and keep the maximum of the two Voronoi outputs. This adds realism because the lines won't be perfectly parallel anymore. To make the result denser, add a map range node and only change the interpolation to smoother step. This increases the contrast. For more details about this node, I'm preparing a video on the topic. The starting point is an edge node, which you can find in the Materializer menu by pressing F. First, set the distance to 0.13 and use one of the two Voronoi textures. Then I add a map range node to invert the mask by switching the output values. You can see the coloring follows the contour well, but we've lost the lines. To bring them back, use a multiply node to combine the edges and lines. And there you go. For more variation, reduce the lower value of the first Voronoi. You can see the important parameter is the distance input of the edge node. The last step is to make the small line that follows the contour. Take a new edge node and duplicate it. Make the top one have a bigger distance than the bottom one. Then subtract the second mask from the first. And there is our line. It's not finished yet, but that's the base. Take the distance value from the very first edge node. Drag the connector and add a value node and move it close to the new nodes. Connect the two edge nodes, making sure to add an addition of about 0.2 before the first node. Now, we need to deform it a bit. Add a noise node in 4D using the UVs with a scale of 10 and connect it to the texture input of the first edge node. Duplicate the noise node, change the seed and use it for the second edge node. Now it's time to mix this with the grid. Add a mix color node with the grid in the first input and black in the second. The factor is our line. If we look closely at the black line, we can see it lacks density and is a bit too blurry. I have a trick for you.
Here's the moment of the developer's tip.
Select an edge node and press Tab to open it. Inside, find the ambient occlusion node and increase the sample count. The higher the count, the sharper the result. But be careful, these are samples, so they take more time to calculate. These affect the render time, depending on the area on the screen. Up close, like here, the difference is clear, but from far away, it's less noticeable. Anyway, that's the trick. Use the new result as input A in the mix color node. And this is looking pretty good. I want the coloring to cover the black line a little less. So I will add a math node to create a small offset. As always, the devil is in the details. The shader is ready. Stick with me for 2 more minutes just for fun. Select the cube and in the materials list, click on the number. This number shows how many objects are using that material. Now, we have an independent version of the material, which I rename with the red suffix. You can guess why. Let's change the color using the hexadecimal code BB0200. Do the same with the star, click on the number, add the yellow suffix, and change the color to DDC717. Select the principal BSDF, press F and click the Mix Layers button. Select the layer and Mix Layers nodes and connect them with the Link button. Then select the Mix Layers and add a new layer. This layer will hold the decal. Select the node, open the menu and click on Add Image. Choose the file smile.png. The add-on has placed an empty object in the scene. Press G and hold Ctrl to move it over the star. When you go back to the star, you will see a decal node has appeared. Connect its color output to the color input of the layer and the mask output to the mask input of the mix layers. And now we have a smiling star. Isn't that cute? Okay, repeat the process for the red cube. Add a mix layer, a new layer, and a decal. This time, select the file angry.png. Once again, move the empty with G and Ctrl Alt down. Connect the decal node to the layer and the mix layers. By scaling the empty object, you will scale the decal too. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial as much as I did. Big thanks to Nickname for getting me started on this. Feel free to join the Discord, links are in the description. I will see you next time, and until then, remember, we get tired of everything except learning. Bye bye.